Okay. If I keep my shoulders parallel, I can get an okay cross face, but it's not the best I can do. This here, you might be a little bit uncomfortable, but it's not going to be too bad. But the moment I start sharing my weight with Chris, and then turning my shoulders up, it's a bad cross face. Okay, it's one where you just, you really start kind of punishing the person, okay? So we're just gonna do our normal cross, or just a nice cross face where you just here. Okay? We're gonna turn our chin away from their frame, because if I'm here kind of pushed down, he's just gonna push against my neck and I'll choke myself. So I turn my chin away and I put my head down, so it's kind of hard for him to see what I'm doing. And I'm gonna take his lapel. Same side lapel, so belt this side. I pull his lapel out of his belt. From here, you want to kind of give it a tug down, because you don't want it to be all caught up here trying to feed it to my hand. I can't. Okay, so give it a nice tug down and tug out. And then you feed it to your hand. Here. Okay. Here, boom. Feed it to your hand. Okay. Now comes kind of the part where you kind of have to let them think they're escaping a little bit. Okay. So as he kind of starts to turn to his side, I'm gonna block his knee with my hips, okay? And you can do that, I don't have to have a lapel to do that. If they start escaping and start, I always block their knee with my hips, okay? But I want him to start turning on his side a little bit, okay? So once this happens, what I typically do is I block the knee and then I bring my knee up close to their hip here, because the more he turns on his side, the better for me. And then I kind of give him my ankle to make him feel like they're going into half guard or something, but it's not. It's actually just kind of helping my control a little bit. Okay, so now I'm up. Notice I'm not like trying to smash right now. I'm up, but I'm sitting back. My butt is kind of on his top leg. Okay, so now I'm gonna feed this hand and grab the lapel with this hand on this side of his neck. Okay. If I have long arms and I'm able to reach under and feed it to here, do it. Sometimes you can't though. Sometimes I come in here and they block with their elbow. Yeah, trying to get it here and they're not letting me. So then just come in front. Thumb up. So the blade of my wrist is against his neck right now. Okay. It's part of my wrist. Right against his neck here. Okay. Like this. Might feel a little bit awkward, but it's just like kind of like a cross collar choke. Okay. So from here, this hand now is going to go for this lapel. But a little tip here: sometimes this lapel, the same lapel that I'm grabbing, it's kind of hard to grab. Especially if this is like a tight fit and you have this grip really tight, it's hard to grab. So you can grab tail back here, this loose fabric here. Grab that. Pull and bring your elbow down. Okay. To finish the choke, some people come here and squeeze. I think that's too much arms. It uses too much arms. So I'm gonna use my weight. So my head, I'm gonna bring my head right over here. Okay. So as I pull my elbows close to my stomach, I bring my head to this side and down. And that'll finish the choke. Alright. So, I'm here, he's got good frames. If this frame is really bugging you guys, just cup the elbow, push it in, okay? So you can kind of hide with your head. Loosen up the lapel, feed it to your other hand, okay? Kind of loosen up a little bit, maybe sink back so they think that they're gonna escape, walk his knee with your hip. Maybe give them your foot. Oh, feel like they're gonna go somewhere, but they're not. Okay. One thing you don't wanna do, or one thing you wanna be just really aware of, is this underhook. If he starts looking for this underhook, you gotta kinda watch out, okay? If he gets this underhook, I'm not gonna do this. I'm just gonna go right for this choke and then sink my way right here. So now he doesn't have an underhook anymore. Okay? Either way, I get the lapel,
with my top arm like this. I'd look to get this choke. Sometimes this is hard, so I grab the fabric right here. Grab the fabric, bring your elbow right next to your other elbow. So now the blade of my wrist is against his neck here. Okay? Now to do the choke, I just bring my leg over to the same side my body is, down to the mat. Pull my elbows into me for the choke. Any questions on that? You don't have to have your foot, you know, trapped here. You can get it from side control. I feel that it's more, a little bit more control over their body when you're here. Whereas, like, if I'm just totally loose right here, you know, he can kind of freak out, flail around. Yeah, he gets his head underneath it. It's kind of a pain in the butt. Where this here, if you know, if I'm going for it here, if he's trying to move around, I have better control over his body. I can sit on his leg a little bit, kind of feel where his hips are going, and then set up the choke. Okay. Any questions on that? Or you guys want to see it again?
What if you can't grab fabric? Can you just cup the shoulder with the?
You can still finish the choke that way. If you have this, like this, if you can't grab anything, you should be able to grab something here. If you can't, you can still grab the shoulder, grab fabric on the shoulder, and still finish it this way. But it's really strong to do it this way. That's why I said sometimes the lapel is hard to get. Grab the fabric because it's loose. You can pull it and be where it needs to be. Okay. But yeah, the shoulder will still work. This can be a little bit looser. Any other questions? Just remember to put your head on the same side of your body when you pull in the shoulders or your elbows again. Yeah. All right, same partners, ends up. 1, 2, 3. He's mobile. Look at his hips. He can escape, he can get underneath. Yeah, it's gonna cause a lot of problems for me. Especially if he gets that knee on the inside, I'm done. And now I gotta watch out for arm bars.
Yeah.
Okay, so you gotta control him. So this, he's not gonna go anywhere. Yeah, he might be doing that kind of thing, but it's not much for me to get on the inside and re-establish my control.
I guess Josh did a good job of like bringing his knee up and stuff
like going over this.
Yeah, just kind of fade it in, so.
Yeah, I mean, if they are doing that kind of thing, it's not hard to open your elbow, push them back like that. And then that gets you on the inside of their knee. Can you put your knee up and over my arm? Pretty hard, especially if I'm on his bottom leg. And then I can come here and get close again. My body needs to be close too. You know, I wanna, as I'm feeding it like this, I don't wanna be like, okay, so I get to here, you know, I don't wanna be like, yeah, well, and there's just a ton of space for them to stick stuff in, right? So, you know, if I'm here, I keep everything close. Don't want to have any space until I'm ready to do something with the space. Or at least I know that I'm going to be okay with the space. Okay? Does that make any sense?
Yeah.
Answer your question.
Yeah, I guess what I was saying is that Josh was using
the hip and stuff. Yeah. That can be a pain, and that can, you know, that's something to deal with, too, you know. But it's hard for them to extend. Like if he's trying to extend and get his posture, it's going to be kind of hard. And plus, I can always come back to side control and work on different. There's different chokes from here too. I can finish the choke other ways. So back to here, right? We get to, everything else is the same. The setup and everything. Let's go through the whole setup here. Here. Boom. Feed the bell. Get to here. He turned. Block with my hip. Feed at my ankle. Boom. He gets to here. Okay. Maybe I try to go this way, but it's hard. So I just go over the top. Okay. Really try to get deep here. Don't just settle for this. Okay. Yeah, you don't want to settle for that. Try to, you know, lower your shoulder and reach. Feet to there. You want a good solid grip there. Okay? So from here, I get this grip and I'm looking for this, but he decides he's gonna block with this hand. He's not gonna let me get this grip. Okay, kind of knows what's going on. Maybe he's kind of blocking my arm or whatever, but he's not letting me get this. So what I do is I go for this, let him defend, and then switch to his elbow. Okay, so I go from here, cup to his elbow. Now I kind of drive my weight. I'm not just gonna pull, I'm gonna pull and drive my weight as I straighten my arm. Okay, I don't want this arm to stay bent the whole time. So as I pull his arm over, I straighten this arm, okay? Then my bicep is gonna bend right over the top of his tricep. And I come straight down here, like I'm trying to put my shoulder down here. You don't wanna go shoulder to shoulder with this choke. You can finish it, but it takes a lot of gas, okay? So I'm here, boom, go right over the top of his tricep. It's a really tight choke. Okay, so everything else the same, we'll set it up. We'll start from here, boom, over the top, feet deep. Try to grab everything. Don't settle for fingers in like this. Okay, grab it like a handle, okay? I'm looking to grab this, but he's like defending. Switch to his elbow, move my body over. Okay, I gotta create room for his elbow to pass. If I'm too close, if I'm trying to pull this over, his elbow's just gonna hit my arm, I can't get it over. Okay, so I gotta straighten my arm, move his elbow over. My shoulder goes right down, straight over here. I'm gonna be right on the back of his tricep. Straighten my arm, I'll bend it straight down. Put your weight. Any questions on that? Good? Okay, hands up. One, two, three.